Hello students, this is Professor Sagar Pirje and I welcome you all for the online class of analog and digital electronics. So in this today's class we will be discussing on Karnaugh map techniques for using minimizing the Boolean expression. So let us start with the introduction to the Karnaugh map. A Karnaugh map, in short known as K-map, is a pictorial method used to minimize Boolean expressions without having to use Boolean algebra theorems and equations manipulation. So here we are going to use a pictorial method, also known as the graphical method, for minimizing the Boolean expression. So previously we used Boolean algebra theorems for minimizing the Boolean expression. The next step that we are going to make use of, or the next method that we are going to make use of in minimizing the Boolean expression, is your K-map method, which is a pictorial method for minimizing the Boolean expressions. So a K-map can be thought of as a special version of a truth table. So it was developed by Karnaugh, the person who brought this method for pictorial method for minimizing the Boolean expression in the year 1953. So on his name we have this K-map, or the Karnaugh map method for simplifying the Boolean expressions. So it is basically used to simplify the Boolean expressions. So basically when we use a K-map expression, if it is of 2, 3 or 4 variables, so it is very easy to minimize the Boolean expression. But if we are using a K-map for the expression which contains 5, 6, 7 variables in the given Boolean expression, then it becomes very or extremely difficult to minimize the expression using K-map. It's not impossible, but the difficulty level is more. So basically in this session we will be only focusing on the 2, 3 and 4 variables K-map techniques in minimizing the Boolean expression. So the diagram below illustrates the correspondence between the K-map and the truth table for the general case of a two variable problem. Just we are showing here the truth table representation in a K-map. So here we have two variables A and B, and the output column, that is F, we can find the different values A, B, C, D that will be represented in the cells or the square blocks of your two variable K-map. So the values inside the squares, the values that is A, B, C and D, okay, are copied from the output column. Now this is what is your output column, okay, of the truth table. This is your truth table, and from the output column of the truth table we have copied the values in those square boxes, okay, or we call them as a cells. So around the edge of the Karnaugh map are the values of the two input variables. So the values of the two input variable along the edge of this square Karnaugh map is 0, 1. Here it is 0 and 1. So either the value of B will be 0 or it will be 1. Similarly, the value of A, variable A, can be either 0 or 1. So A is along the top and B is on the down the left hand side. So here we can find A is on the top and B, variable B, is down the left hand side. Okay, so this is what it is. Here is the diagram below explains this. We have two variables A and B in this truth table. The value of A and B can be 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 or 1, 1. So at a given point of time, suppose if this is how we represent the K-map. So at the top we represent A, and the bottom hand we represent the left side, we represent the B. So at a given point of time, the value of A can either be 0 or it can be 1. Okay, it cannot hold two values simultaneously, as we are dealing with binary zeros and ones. So either it input variable can hold only one value at a given point of time. It can be either 0 or 1. Similarly for B, at a given point of time, either it can be a 0 or it can be 1. Fine. So suppose we have input value to A is 0 and B is 0. Okay. So from the output column of the truth table, this is the output column of the truth table. Okay. For the value of A is 0 and B is 0. So A is 0 here, B is 0. So when A is 0 and B is also 0, go to the output column. What is that? We find here 0. So this 0 is written here. Fine. So now you see the next row of the truth table. We have A value as 0 and B value as 1. So we keep this A value as 0 here and B value as 1. So when A is 0 here, when A is 0 here, and when the B value is 1. So what do you find? That we have a value 1 here. We write that value 1 in this particular cell. Okay. Now we move on to the third row here. This is the third row in the truth table. What we have? A value is 1 here. A value is 1 and B value is 0. So B value is 0, A value is 1. What do you find? 1 here. So this is 1 that is coming out here. Okay, for the value of A is 1 and B is 0. And the last row in this truth table, what we have is A as 1 and B as 1. So A is also 1 and B is also 1. So what is that we are going to write here? 1. So this is how normally from a truth table values we like to construct a k-map. And then how we simplify the expression, we'll see later. Just remember, how do we put the output values from the column of a truth table into a k-map representation for a two variable. Okay, this is just a general example for representing the k-map and the truth table for a two variable. Next, let us first understand the k-map rules of simplification. These rules are going to be applied whenever we are trying to minimize the Boolean expression. Okay, some of the rules that we need to remember, understand, and then apply during the k-map simplification technique is, first of all, we are not going to consider zeros. So no zeros are allowed to be represented in the k-map. Okay, so no diagonals. So diagonal elements cannot be grouped in a, or diagonal cells cannot be grouped in a k-map. So we'll be looking it with an example what we mean by this no zeros allowed or no diagonal elements are allowed. Okay, so grouping of diagonal elements. So the third rule says that only power of two number of cells in each group, that is whenever we are grouping the cells, it should be always a power of 2, that is 2, 4, 6, 8 and so on. Okay, so 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay, fine. These are the number of cells that we are going to group. So grouping should be as large as possible. So as I told, whenever we are trying to group the cells, try to check how many ones are present adjacent to each other. If the group says that we have 8 adjacent ones present together, we can group it. If not 4, if not 2, fine. So everyone must be in at least one group. You have to ensure that everyone that is represented in a cell should be at least grouped in one of the either group. Okay, overlapping is allowed. So we can overlap the number of ones that are present in the cell in order to group them. Wrapping around is also allowed. Okay, and then fewest number of groups are also possible. So few number of groups also can be grouped and can be used in simplification of the Boolean expression. Okay, so it's not that only large number of groups are only to be considered. It's not that fewest number of groups is also possible. So let us look each of these rules one by one. So the Karnaugh map uses the following rules for the simplification of expression by grouping together adjacent cells containing ones. Remember, this word is very, very important. Adjacent cells containing ones. Okay, wherever we have. Now see here, groups may not include any cell containing a zero. So if a cell in the truth table where the cell output column says it is a zero, so zero cannot be clubbed with one. So this is completely wrong. I cannot group a zero with one, even though we have adjacency. Okay, you can say this cell is adjacent with this. This cell is again adjacent with this, and this cell is adjacent with this, and this cell is adjacent to this. So these two cells are adjacent, these two cells are adjacent, these two cells are adjacent, and these two cells are adjacent. So whereas the other two cells are not adjacent, we'll be explaining here. Now here we can see in the next example, this is right. There is a one present in the cell where value of A is 0 and B is 1 here, and there is a 1 present here. So as these two cells contain 1 and they are adjacent to each other, we can group these two ones. Okay, this is correct, whereas this is wrong. Okay, so we cannot group 0 and 1. First thing, if there was, instead of this 0, if there was a 1 present here, then we could have grouped it. Instead of 0, if there had been a 1 here, then we could have grouped it. But this is not the case here. Why? Because presently we have grouped a 0, which is completely wrong. But whereas here, if there is a 1 here, we can group this. So see here, we are not grouped here. Grouped 0 with this. We have grouped the 1s here. So this is correct. So groups may not include any cell which is containing 0. So only the cells which contain 1 should be grouped. Remember that first. Okay. So groups may be horizontal or vertical, but not diagonal. What do you mean by that? So group may be either horizontal or vertical. Okay. But they cannot be diagonal. So diagonal cells cannot be grouped, even though there are ones present in that cell. There is a one present in this cell, there is a one present in this cell. I cannot group these two ones. Okay, this rule doesn't apply. Okay, so diagonal elements in the cell cannot be grouped. Okay, whereas the elements present either vertically or horizontally can be grouped. So remember this rule, which is very, very important. In some of the examples, you may come across such cases while solving that there is a diagonal elements present, but we cannot group it. You can have to group it individually. So this is not possible here. Okay. So the next rule says that the group must contain 1, 2, 4, 8, or in general 2 raised to n cells. As I said, a grouping of ones can be done if there is no grouping. Okay, in the previous example, if there is only single one present, you can group it. Then you try to go out with 2, 4, 8, 16, and so on. So that is one thing. So that is, if n is equal to 1, a group will contain 2 ones. Since 2 raised to 1 is equal to 2, if n is equal to 2, group will contain 4 ones. Since 2 raised to 2 is equal to 4. So here you can see, there are 2 ones present here. We are going to group. This is the right one. See, if there are 3 ones, even though they are adjacent to each other, So this one is adjacent to this and this one is adjacent to this. We cannot group three ones here. We cannot group three ones. So it could be either 1, 2. This is power of 2. Remember that. Whenever you are grouping the ones in a cell, it should be power of 2. So this is completely wrong. So group 3 is wrong. Here you can see a group of 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. All 4 ones are adjacent to each other. This one is adjacent to this. This one is adjacent to this. You may say that if I can group this one independently and this one independently, or either I can group this one and this one, this one. No. If there are 4 ones in the cell and all cells are adjacent to each other, then we go for a maximum grouping. So we have to first look for a maximum grouping. If the maximum grouping is not possible, then we go for the next maximum grouping. If suppose in this example, if we take, if I am not able to group 8 ones, then I will look for the next maximum grouping, that is 4. If I don't have here, in this case, we have, see here, in group number 5, how many cells I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So suppose if all 8 cells had, instead of these 3 zeros, okay, if I had 1 here, 1 here, 1 here and 1 here, then I could have grouped all these 4 ones, okay, and I could have given a maximum grouping of 8, okay, which is not possible, fine, which is not possible here, okay, which is not possible here. So here, as we have 8 number of ones not present here, okay, so we are not grouping here. See here, what is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this group number 5 has 5 ones and I cannot group this. So first rule, I had told that zeros should not be a part of this group. So I have included 0 here. So this group is completely wrong. Here, this group is right because here I have used, just a minute, here I have used the 4 ones. I have grouped all 4 ones. So 8 is not possible in this because there are only 4 cells. So 4, this is correct. Whereas here, this is completely wrong. So here what I can do, how do I group this? So here if you see, instead of grouping all this, which is completely wrong, why? Because here I have considered zeros, which is in this grouping, in a dotted blue color line, which is completely wrong. I am not going to do that. Okay, so what I am supposed to do here now? Okay, so here you can see that, just an example I am telling you, if I want to group this in a proper order, what I will do, you can see this one is adjacent to this, this one is adjacent to this and this one. So in this, there are 4 number of groupings. So I group this. Okay, this is correct. And you can see there is a 1 present here. Is there anyone adjacent here? No. Is there anyone adjacent here? Check out with horizontal and vertical grouping. Yes. Then I go with this. So this is the right way. This is the right way of grouping. Okay, in the example, just I'm trying to say that there should be a maximum number of grouping that you need to do so that we can minimize the expression in a better way. So zeros should not be included while grouping. You see that the grouping must be the power of 2, that is 2, 4, 8, 16 and so on. Okay, so you should not include zeros. The grouping should be in a proper order. Okay, adjacent to each other. Okay, so the next what you have is the each group should be as large as possible. That's what I said. Each group should be as large as possible. Now see here, in this example, if you look here, there is a 1, 1, 1, 1 present here, 1, 1 present here. So what happens if I group this individual? This is completely wrong. Try to check out if I can go with a maximum grouping. maximum grouping of how many cells are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 cells are there. All cells contains 1? No. If all cells would have contained 1, then I could have grouped those with 8. Okay, 8 grouping. But as these two cells are having zeros, so possibility of grouping of 8 ones is not there. Now, which is the next maximum grouping? 4. Are there 4 ones present in the cell which are adjacent to each other? Then you can group. Yes, there are 4 ones which are adjacent to each other. Which are those? 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay. Now I group this. So this is the right way. Yes. Now check out with the left out one. Now these two ones are the left out one. Understanding? Now for this cell is the adjacent one. For this cell is the adjacent one. So we have to group it. So even though we have considered these two ones in this group, because of the maximum grouping is possible for this one, I have to group this. So we can group this. If I group these two ones, again it may result into an additional product term or variable coming in a Boolean expression. We have to minimize. Our aim is to minimize the Boolean expressions. Okay. So sufficient minimum expressions. This is what it is. Sufficiently minimal expression need to be done. So that's what this is. How we have told that this is completely wrong way of minimizing the expression. Okay, grouping the terms in the K-map. Okay, this is not there. So try to group large. So here you can see, here we have, this is one and this is one. So we have two groups. Instead of having three independent groups with minimum grouping, we go with the maximum grouping of four groups. Okay, hope you have understood it. Fine. So go for a maximum grouping. So first 8, then 4, 2 and so on. If it is more than 8, 16, 16, 8, 4, 2, 1. So like that. If it is a 5 variable. Okay. 4 variable it is. Okay, it goes to 16. Next, each cell containing a 1 must be at least in a 1 group. Okay, each cell containing a 1, each cell containing at least a 1 must be at least in 1 group. Okay, so see here, this group is 1, this is the second group. So there is 1 present at least in 1 group. Okay, so this one can be grouped here, but at least there should be 1 present in each group. So this is one thing. Groups may overlap. Now groups may overlap in the sense what? Now see here, there is 1 1 1 1, 4 ones present in this particular group, and these two ones are there. Even though these ones are already grouped in this particular along with these two adjacent number of ones, we can take this. So this is the right way. Instead of having independent one, you can overlap. Don't do it independent. You have to overlap the ones and you have to group it so that we can achieve the maximum grouping in the cells of the cells. Okay, so this is the right way. This is the complete wrong way. So individually don't try to group it. Even if there are ones which are adjacent and already they are being considered in the other group, no matter, we have to consider them in the grouping of the second group. So this technique we call it as overlapping technique. Okay, so hope you have understood this concept of overlapping. Okay, the next concept what we have is groups may wrap around the table. Okay, the leftmost cells in a row may be grouped with the rightmost cells, and the topmost cells in a column may be grouped with the bottommost cell. Okay, so here what I'm trying to say is, whenever we are talking about wraparound, so if you just see, there are ones present in this cell. Okay, forget about this part, the ones which are present in the center. We have one present here, we have one present here, we have one present here, and we have one present here. So you may say that they are not adjacent, but if you fold this, if you join this corner with this and this corner with this. Just fold this. What will happen? These two cells will be adjacent to these two cells. Okay. Similarly, if you see the topmost column cell and the columns that are present in the bottom, similarly I can wrap it. Okay, this is what we call it as wrapping. So you don't say that we cannot do that, okay, or you cannot wrap like this. This is one of the technique what we have. Okay, so here you can see this. Okay, now here this is the one present here, there is one present here, there is one present in this cell and in this cell. So try to group this. So this is possible. So one possibility is okay, you go with this one and this one. Okay, you can go with this one and this one. That is what you have said. If not okay, the other possibility of maximum grouping. If you try to think of maximum grouping, then we have the best solution is these two cells, you are grouping with these two cells. So this is how we wrap around the rightmost cells and the topmost cells with the bottom and the left side of the row. Okay, there should be as few groups as possible as long as this does not contradict with any of the previous rules. Okay, so once again we are telling there should be few number of groups. So don't, even though these are adjacent, you don't say that okay, I am going to group this one with this, sir, and this one in this and this one in this. So try to create minimum number of groups. Okay, try to use all the techniques. First check out whether I can group the maximum number of ones. Yes, there is a possibility of grouping maximum number of ones. Yes, I can use the overlapping technique even though these ones are already grouped with the other ones. Yes, this is also possible. So instead of having three different groups, I can have only two groups. So you try to minimize the groups and try to group the maximum number of runs which are adjacent to each other. So this is what the rules says. Hope you have understood it fine. So this is all about today's class. In the next class we will be continuing to study and understand about k-map minimization. So whatever concept that we have started today with k-map, try to go through it, try to understand the rules that we are going to use in minimizing the Boolean expression using k-map technique. So there should be no zeros that are to be grouped. Okay, cells with adjacent ones need to be grouped. Okay, then there should be maximum grouping. Overlapping is possible. Try to create groupings with the power of 2, that is 2, 4, 8 and 16. So if there is a possibility of creating maximum group, okay, with all ones present, try to do that. If not, then look for the next maximum number. That is, if 16 grouping is not possible, then go for 8. If 8 grouping is not possible, then go for 4. If 4 is not possible, then go for 2, and so on. Don't try to create maximum number of groups. Try to minimize the groups by grouping maximum number of ones. This is what it is. We'll be also looking with more problems of different rules getting applied and how we can simplify it. Till now, you just try to focus on the rules and try to understand them. So same rules you will be applying in simplifying the expression using different examples. So thank you for watching this video. In the next video, we'll continue with the k-map minimization technique. Thank you.